Iraq is seeing another devastating wave of COVID infections, averaging more than 3,000 a day this past week. There are fears the nation's healthcare workers will be overwhelmed, with one Baghdad hospital seeing patient numbers triple in just 2 weeks. And CNN's Arwa Damon joins us now from Baghdad, where she gained rare access inside an ICU ward. So, Arwa, what is the latest on infections and hospitalizations? And what did you find inside that ICU?
Well, Rosemary, those new variants are causing great concern here as well as they are in many other countries. And when we went inside the ICU, we encountered something quite unexpected. There was a certain warmth to the entire experience, something that is in many ways uniquely Iraqi despite all of the suffering.
The constant beeping of the machines is mind-numbing, but at least here there is something rarely seen inside a COVID-19 intensive care unit. Those struggling for each breath are not alone. Amni's weak laugh is muffled, an inside joke shared with the doctors about how her daughter, Neba, is constantly hovering over her. The family went to a wedding. No masks, no social distancing. A decision they all bitterly regret. I also have COVID, but I've forgotten about it with the state my mother is in, Nabat says as her voice starts to crack. We filled the house with oxygen tanks, but it wasn't enough, and then we brought her here. Amna nods her head. She is doing much better now. Wafat's family also tried to treat her using oxygen at home. They did not want to bring her to a hospital, not an uncommon occurrence in Iraq.
Why do you think people are reluctant to come to the hospital initially?
Maybe because of Iraqi culture.
For some, it's fear of being stigmatized, having caught a virus that has brought the world to its knees. There are people even now who say, "What is this corona?" Wafat's daughter Niran tells us they don't believe the virus exists until it hits them. But it's also a misunderstanding that oxygen and vitamins are enough to treat the symptoms of the virus. And there's also a lack of faith in Iraq's healthcare systems, which have yet to fully recover from sanctions dating back to the Saddam Hussein era and then nonstop war.
This is a very bad thing to keep patient in treatment at home.
Iraq's first COVID-19 wave devastated the country. Hospitals were overwhelmed. This particular infectious diseases hospital in Baghdad that the government facilitated our access to saw its patient numbers triple in the last 2 weeks.
Are you ready for maximum capacity or more?
We have beds, we have doctors, we have nurses.
And they do not have a choice.
2 months ago, the virus nearly from Iraq, deleted from all Iraq people. So all people leave face mask, leave sterilization, leave everything, neglected everything, neglected all the protection.
Does this make you stressed? Does this make you worried?
Sure. We are afraid of our family, ourselves from this new virus, but we should do what we can and the benefit for the patients.
By new virus, Dr. Ayla means new variant. Iraq's Ministry of Health recently stated that 50% of the new infections are of the highly contagious B117 variant, first identified in the UK. The government only just made face masks mandatory and re-implemented stricter restrictions like nighttime and weekend curfews. It should have happened before, not now at the end, Niran says of the government's measures, as her mother's chest heaves with each labored breath. She won't leave her side, no matter the risk, no matter the circumstances. In Iraq, no one stays in a hospital alone.
And Rosemary, there was some level of frustration being expressed by the medical workers in that particular hospital that vaccinations have not yet begun here. We did then reach out to the Ministry of Health, who says that they hope to start them by the end of the month.
Arwa Damon, we thank you for that remarkable story, bringing us that from Baghdad. Many thanks.